Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this is Many a True Nerd, and welcome back to Fallout New Vegas Survive Mode with the Jay Sawyer mod. Last time we returned to Freeside, made some friends, made some enemies, started a small war, and the Doctors Who had no guns ended up winning that war, which was very, very interesting. And today, well, as you can see, we've come to Camp Forlorn Hope. And, well, you can probably guess what flipping mod I've installed already. Yeah, I've installed Fallout, which, for those of you who are not aware, was a mod back in the days of Fallout 3, which got rid of kind of like the big green colour filter that existed over large parts of Fallout 3. And they brought it forward into Fallout New Vegas, where it removed part of the kind of the worst of the filters, the coloured filters, over the game. Now, I'm divided on this one, which is, as you can see, as we've headed into Camp Forlorn Hope here, it's got rid of the really, really strong red filter, which I approve of. I think that's a good thing, and I understand like it gets rid of the green filter around the radiation areas, which I'm okay with, to be honest. Like, I think this looks a lot better here. Camp Forlorn Hope looks a lot better than usual. I don't know why the red filter needs to be as strong as it has to be. However, there are some other changes this makes that I'm not quite so keen on, but we'll get to those later. Because as far as I can tell, there's no like setup tool for this thing. You either have to have 100% of what it offers or none of what it offers. So we'll see the bits I don't like shortly. Anyway, we're not actually here at Camp Forlorn Hope. I just wanted to show off that Camp Forlorn Hope looks a lot better. So here we go. It's now 8:30 at night, and indeed the other half of this mod has kicked in, which is, it does the whole darker nights thing, where flames obviously produce light, but if you're not actually kind of under a flame, it gets very, very dark indeed. In fact, like, right here, this is a level of darkness I consider a little bit too dark. Like, I like this idea conceptually, the fact that, you know, if you weren't, like, near a light source, there should be limited light, but I just kind of feel this is a little bit too much, and unfortunately there's no way to turn off the darker nights thing while keeping the filter thing. So you know what, we'll try this out for this episode, but I might turn it off, because this is just too flipping dark outside, I think, in my opinion. Though on the other hand, it does create some really quite strikingly beautiful little scenarios here, like, you know, this little camp lit up but surrounded by darkness, or the Novak sign kind of glowing in the night. That's nice. I like that. I just wish I could turn the brightness in the night just up a little bit. Because, of course, while I do have the Pip-Boy, which, it was already on. I was trying to turn it on, not realizing it was already on. Yeah, back in Fallout 3 in New Vegas, your Pip-Boy light was really weird, which was, it was, the light was only really, really close to it. Produced a really weird localized light source. Light doesn't really, you know, work like this, but that's how it works in Fallout 3 in New Vegas. So, the Pip-Boy light is basically useless to you lighting this up. But, ooh, that's quite pretty. That might be a bit OTT. And we've slept through to the following morning so I can actually bloody see what's going on. Marvellous. Anyway, today, in fact, we're going to head over and do a little bit of business with Caesar's Legion. After all, we were, in fact, invited to the fort a couple of parts ago, and it would be nice to see Cottonwood Cove when it too doesn't have the ridiculously OTT red filter on it. So, yeah. This mod, I'm very, very divided about, which is, I really like the fact it's got rid of the ridiculously OTT filter. I'm not so 100% keen on the Dark Knights thing, and sadly, I just can't do anything about that, unless I install another mod that exists to make knights lighter, but I'm not sure about that. Speaking of which, this area seems to have not repopulated, so the huge number of people who were dead because I killed them, they're all still dead. That's a shame, no one else is back here. Which is a shame, because one of the people I killed, who normally stands right here, you can basically turn in NCR dog tags to him for infinite Legion fame. I'm a bit worried about my Legion fame. I'm not sure how I'm going to get my Legion fame up, but we shall see. The one Legion person who's actually bloody left, the guy who's going to take me to the fort. Even if I kill him now, I can just get on the boat anyway and kind of go up to the fort by myself, which is nice. Fun fact, by the way, though I kind of shot everyone and killed them to maximize the number of corpses so I could get the ears, if you get that thing up there, that lorry, you can just kind of crack open the back of it and radioactive barrels fall into the town. And the NCR likes that. They think it's kind of fitting revenge for the dirty bomb that was set up over in Camp Searchlight. This area remains permanently irradiated. And if you do that, this guy here is wearing an advanced radiation suit because that's the only way he can safely be in this area, which is quite funny. Anyway, Cursor Lucullus, why don't you take me up to the fort and we'll see what we can do there.
By order of Kaisar, all visitors must disarm and relinquish all banned items. This order also extends to the platinum chip you carry. for now.
And of course, because I've got sneak over 50, I can keep my holdout weapons anyway. And if you dig into what he's saying a bit more, what exactly is a banned item?
Alcohol and all chems, including stims and other addictive items.
Unfortunately, speech 35, I'm gonna need to bring them along anyway.
I know not why Kaisar would wish to speak with such a physically inferior whelp, but I will allow this one exception. You may bear Kaisar's mark, but do not attempt to share any of your medicine with anyone in the fort.
Marvelous, and I'll keep my holdout items too, thank you very much. There we are, so I've lost the platinum chip and some but not all of my guns. So I've still got a good number of solid weapons here. Lucky, I've still actually got it on my side. That's the weapon I happen to have installed. So literally you can see the gun on my hip. You know what? Just for the sake of role playing, we're gonna take that off. Lovely. And they can't take the camera because that's a quest item that's stuck in your inventory forever. No one can ever take that camera off you. You'll also notice a trench running in both directions. Off to the left here, there's nothing interesting. However, if you follow this one round to the right, you actually get something out of it, even though there's nothing else around here other than one little item to pick up. It's quite a jaunt, by the way, and the item's not very good, but it is here. There we are, one ammo box of surplus ammo. And then once you've got that, honestly, it's probably fastest to fast travel back to the fort. There you are, just saved myself 30 seconds of running there, marvellous. And then, of course, we've got this lovely shop here, Dale Barton. And of course, as you'd reasonably suspect, this guy doesn't actually sell you any guns. He'll sell you like a couple of mods and stuff, and he'll sell like a little bit of random stuff. He sells a load of cards, by the way, if you're collecting cards, but mainly he just sells aid. Very appropriate, of course. In the camp, you're not allowed to carry weapons, so obviously he doesn't sell any weapons, he just sells food. Dale's also interesting because from him you get the hint of where Obsidian clearly kind of wanted the Legion to go if they had more time to develop the game. So rather than being kind of like the fairly morally indefensible bad guys they are in the final game, Dale provides like the hint of an alternative way of defending the Legion. So if you ask him if it's dangerous to trade with the Legion...
Not at all. They're my best customers. As long as you don't try to sell them chems or alcohol, they treat you fair. Hell, I don't even need to travel with guards most of the time in Legion territory. All the bandits are dead or run off.
So just a very, very slight hint there that actually, though the Legion, when they take over an area, it's a monstrously terrible genocidal process, after they've rolled through, could the area they've created actually be better than what the NCR does? Because if we ask him about trading with the NCR meanwhile...
Between having to hire protection and getting slapped with taxes, it's more profitable to stick to Arizona and New Mexico. But I do cross the river from time to time when an opportunity comes along.
So this guy, in fact, is safer and happier trading with Legion territories. Very, very interesting. Though we don't get very much of this at all, but clearly this is vaguely where Obsidian wanted to go, that, like, the atrocities of the Legion can potentially be justified. The ends might have been able to justify the means, but not much of it makes its way into the final game. And of course, we see the children being trained to be legionaries running up and down the hill, and their trainer right here.
I'm harsh on the children, but they'll be excellent legionaries. I'm quite proud of them.
Though the camp could have been way more developed than what it was, I like the fact that you just get, you know, the starting hints of seeing how the Legion operates. You see the slaves wandering around, you see the children in training, the instructors. Beyond the area you're allowed to go to, of course, you can see, like, all of those tents stretching down to the water. So, you know, it's made perfectly clear you are only seeing a small part of the Legion's strengths. And into the camp proper. Now, if you don't actually have the sneak to get guns into the camp, this is where you can get guns very, very easily, because there's footlockers all over the bloody place. Because they're sort of hidden inside tents, well, this tent's a very bad example, but like most of the tents, it's very, very easy just to kind of get yourself into a position where no one can see you. So here is fine. So I'm straight into hidden, and now we've got all these footlockers. And then we've got ourselves straight away single shotgun. That's pretty terrible. But keep going, 9mm pistol. Not spectacular, but you know, not the worst gun in the game either. Machete as well. What I'm really looking for is hunting rifles. You'll see like a fair few hunting rifles sitting around, so you can get yourself some alright guns. But anyway, like if you don't have guns and you want them, you can get guns inside the camp very, very easily. Hello over there, I need to help you out.
If you're injured, I might have healing powder to spare.
And about the effectiveness of your healing powders, Siri.
What about it? Do you have some advice?
I absolutely do. With Survival 20, I can suggest a more efficient mix.
Oh, I've been using 2 roots per flower. Thanks to you, I'll be able to create twice as much healing powder per day.
So that gives me a bit of Legion fame, as well as a tiny bit of XP. And here's something I've been very much looking forward to. As I'm actually playing a male character on this occasion, I actually get to fight in the arena. Because yes, the Legion is very, very firm on this. There's no speed check or anything you can use to fight in the arena if you're a female character. It's just not allowed. But as a male character, I actually can. So we can actually do some arena fights on this playthrough, which is lovely.
Light armor and machetes only. The challenger, the one who asks to enter the arena, may be pitted against one or more opponents. All matches continue until one side is dead. No exceptions.
Okay, I'd like to fight in the arena in that case.
That can be arranged. You will be facing off against a couple of disobedient slaves. Not much of a challenge, but it might be entertaining to watch.
Sure, let's do it. So as you can see here, the game has just provided me with some leather armor because the armor I was wearing was medium armor, so it wasn't really allowed. And I've also been given a machete. This is in fact officially called gladiator armor with a damage threshold of 12. Lovely. And you'll see I've also been given a machete. All my other guns have been taken away from me, even though like I wasn't supposed to have them in the first place. And they'll be returned to me at the end of the fight, even though, again, I wasn't supposed to have them anyway. And I've still got my camera, which is very, very nice. Obviously, you can use VATS to give yourself a very big advantage. So just dance around them, wait until VATS is filled up, and then simply use VATS to kill these guys. So this is the easiest thing in the world, because obviously you've got VATS defense right now. These guys will be, he's even disarmed. And is that going to be him dead? Not quite, but he's lost his machete. They are still perfectly able to flee, by the way. So in this case, both of them have been disarmed. Where are the... I saw them drop their machetes. I can't see the machete. Never mind, I think you're both dead, so that means you need to... No, you're going down. You are going down, my friend. Lovely. And now I have a new weapon. I shall kill you with legs. And finish him off. Lovely. There we are. With the duel concluded, your regular equipment has been returned to you. So that there's that done. That gets me all of my stuff back, which the game will now tell me about one by one, rather annoyingly. Of course, I can loot these guys' bodies, but they don't have anything on them but slave rags, so no reason you'd actually want their stuff off them. Yeah, the game's gonna give me all of my everything back one by one. Beautiful. This also, of course, does indeed give you more Legion fame. So this is simply Legion fame female characters are not allowed to access, which is a little bit unfair, but then, you know, I guess technically the Legion is incredibly misogynistic, so it makes sense. Let's, however, talk about cheating. Which is, the game, as you saw there, takes all your items off you when you enter the arena, and the arena door is locked, so therefore you don't have anything on you. You don't start with anything on you. It is, however, extremely easy to cheat guns inside the arena. I'm not sure how it's calculated, by the way, but I've always seen better guns spawn down here, in this area, by the weather station, particularly in these bigger rooms on the left. I don't know how exactly that's calculated, it just seems to be the case. There we are, caravan shotgun, that's not too bad. And that's what I really wanted to see, one hunting rifle, lovely. So using those weapons, I could now leave weapons in the arena that I could use. However, I want to use my own weapons to be classy. Also worth bearing in mind, where you start and they start, because they will pick up weapons too. So generally, I think you start near the door and they start near Caesar's tent. So if I put the weapons about here, this should work. So there we are, pew pew and ammo, because a gun without ammo is not very much use. Over to Otho.
There's a captured NCR trooper available, Sergeant Andrews. He's already been challenged once and survived, so he should be a worthy opponent.
Well, you say this, I think I've got a trick up my sleeve too, don't you worry.
Careful in there. He's tougher than he looks.
And here we go, and lovely. So I've got the gladiator armor, he's got himself a machete. Unfortunately for him, I now have pew pew, and no one minds me using this. Yeah, here you go. There you go, I'm not sure this is going very well for you, is it, Sergeant Andrews? One shot to the leg. There we are, that's one leg crippled. That should be him pretty much well screwed. Yeah. And no one minds. Like, they don't run in and, like, say, hey, you cheated or turned you or anything. Nope, you're allowed to use any gun you want. You just try it, Sergeant Andrews. There you go. Down he goes. And with the duel concluded, my regular equipment has been returned to me, and no one whatsoever comments on the blatant cheating. And once again, literally all of my items are returned to me one by one. That's not the only way you can cheat, however. There's another way to cheat, which arguably is even more fun. I should, however, mention first, before we go and do that, just jump down here. A very good way to make money in this game, by the way, is basically clear out the camp, stealing all the shotguns, the caravan shotguns, the hunting rifles, all of that good stuff, and then just go and sell them to Dale, because while he doesn't sell guns, he will buy them. The only downside is he doesn't have a huge amount of money. Though if you happen to need any of the weapon mods he's selling, you can basically trade stuff you can just get for free in the Legion camp for those, which is nice. So nipping back to Freeside, which I can't deny looks really rather special under this mod, I see the appeal of it. I do see the appeal of the Dark Knight. I think kind of in some ways it creates some really, really striking, lovely moments, especially when there's like really bright lights lit up in the darkness. I agree. But mainly, I went to go and get Arcade, or indeed any companion who is not fundamentally hostile. Well, Arcade is fundamentally hostile to the Legion, but I mean he won't actually start shooting. Now, as for why Arcade is here, let's get Arcade up to a nice vantage point. Like, I've just brought him to watch. I kind of just thought, Arcade doesn't get out very much, maybe he'd like just getting to see a lovely gladiatorial fight. Like, how nice will that be for Arcade to be able to see a nice gladiatorial fight? Arcade, yeah, this is about right. So you, wait right here.
Okay, just don't be gone long.
I won't, Arcade. You just stand here overlooking the arena, why don't you? And I think you can roughly guess what's coming up next. I'd like to fight in the arena for a third and final time. Well, third and final time for an arena fight. There's actually going to be more times to go in the arena yet. We'll get to those later.
I have a dangerous one for you. An NCR ranger by the name of Stella. We got lucky since we rarely capture rangers alive. Even though she's a woman, she's killed every man who's faced her in the arena. Even one of the elite Canturians. With her bare hands.
Now this here is actually a little bit odd, because people who know New Vegas very well will actually know this woman is mentioned elsewhere. She's the ranger that's been abducted from Ranger Station Charlie. The problem is, Ranger Station Charlie hasn't been hit yet. Because Ranger Station Charlie stays in NCR hands until you actually speak to Ranger Andy in Novak, and he asks you to check on Charlie, and that's the trigger for Charlie being taken by the Legion, at which point they leave a note saying, "We captured one of the women," and that's the woman who you fight here. She's the ranger who got captured. However, Charlie hasn't actually been hit, but even if it hasn't been hit, she shows up and gets captured anyway. Maybe she got captured while out on patrol, but they just haven't gone and secured the station yet. Who knows? Anyway, let's go fight her.
Watch out for her. She's one of the deadliest fighters I've ever seen.
And you say this, but luckily— oh, what the— I just accidentally— I've never seen that before. I've just slightly accidentally got myself out of the arena by running backwards immediately. Oh no. Okay, I need to get back in. Also, where the bloody hell did Arcade go? Arcade, you were supposed to be shooting down into the arena. That was, like, literally your one job. Fortunately, however, apparently I don't need him because I've just accidentally discovered a new form of cheating I never knew was there before, which is, yes, if you go into third-person camera and then back off immediately, you can actually get out of the arena before the door closes. So, marvellous. Brilliant. Let's go get ourselves a gun. I believe there was a nice 9mm in one of these ones over here.
Thought hiding would save you?
No, I didn't think that hiding would save me. I did, however, think that hiding outside of the arena, going up to a high ledge, and then shooting you in the face might work. You know what? Screw it. I'm going to go back in. I'm going to take her on in a fair fight, or as fair a fight as it can be when I've got guns and she doesn't. There we go. Got her in. Here she comes. Except she's not actually interested in— hello, are you interested in fighting? You might be. Right, now let's use the bullets we've got left in this thing to cripple one of her legs. There we go, critical strike and right leg crippled, lovely. Slightly out of ammo, mind. Lucky I brought this shotgun with me, really. Lovely! Yeah, we go, you just stay down. I said stay down. Alright, you had your warning. And down Stella goes. With the duel concluded, your regular equipment has been returned to you. I will admit, a melee gladiatorial fight is much, much easier when you bring a shotgun.
Put that away.
Oh, now they're angry at me for using guns. Fine. And that there is all of the human fighting you can do in the arena. You'll also notice, by the way, the slave corpses are still there. Though if you ask this guy what he actually does...
I set up the fights, keep track of prisoners available, and make sure the arena's cleaned up.
You are terrible at your job. Now, a few other bits and pieces in the fort. Obviously, down here in a little kind of enclosed caged arena with some Brahmin, we have little Melody here.
I can't talk to you. It's not allowed.
It's totally allowed because I have speech 50.
I guess that's okay. If you're a friend, can you help me?
Totally. What do you need me to do?
Anthony took Sergeant Teddy away and gave him to the stinky dogs. I want him back.
So she wants her teddy back. Meanwhile, if you ask her what she does here...
I help take care of the Brahmin. I sometimes bring water and food to people. That's it.
Yeah, I've always felt that those hesitations and gaps, she's not saying what's really going on here, and I think what's implied to be going on here is very, very disturbing indeed. Ah, good. And now flipping our Kate's back. That was odd. Apparently the fights just take place in a separate pocket dimension where companions don't exist. I genuinely thought you could put a companion up here and he would shoot down into the arena to assist you, but apparently not, but that's okay, because I found a better way of cheating anyway. Alright, okay, as you're apparently useless, off you go, please. Anyway, let's go and get Sergeant Teddy from Anthony here.
The stupid girl should know by now that even the rags on her back are a privilege. Anyway, my mongrels like their new toy. Tell you what, you square off with four of my best dogs. No armor and no weapons except a machete. You survive, and I let you have the bear.
Seems very, very fair indeed. With barter of 50, we can come up with an alternative arrangement, but nope, let's just do this. Also, why do you not mind me killing your best dogs?
I think they'll probably end up killing you. I trained them myself. But if you do win somehow, the mongrels will at least get honorable deaths.
All right, let's do this then.
Good luck. You'll need it.
Yes, luck. I totally need luck. Luck or one shotgun! Yep, think this works better than luck, to be honest. Yep, works just fine. I shotgunned his legs off. And of course, just like everyone else in this bloody game, Anthony does not care in the slightest about the fact I blatantly just cheated.
Take the bear. I can't believe I let some of my best dogs get killed over this stupid thing. Your stuff is in the crate next to the arena entrance. Leave it there too long, and we'll dump it in the lake.
I'm pretty sure it's already actually been returned to me, but never mind. Also, this guy has a fun little bit of information about elsewhere in the world of Fallout that we haven't actually seen in any of the games.
We breed them mostly, but sometimes we get some good ones from Denver. That whole city is overrun with them.
So apparently Denver is entirely overrun by very good quality dogs. Interesting. Alright, Melody, here's the bear.
Thank you.
And that, of course, gets me some nice bonus karma, which is lovely, and karma's very hard to come by. So yes, I'll gladly take the karma. And of course, there is one final arena fight that we can do, related, of course, here to good old Looper. And for that, we're going to need our own dog. And back to the king, let's ask after the dog.
He's been acting peculiar for some time now. I took him to the followers and had him checked out, and they said his brain is bad or something. If you found a way to help my poor Rex here, I'd be much obliged. Your best bet will be to talk to Julie Farkas over at the old Mormon Fort north of here. Maybe you'll have better luck than I did.
And that begins nothing but a hound dog. Let's go have a quick chat with Julie, as my inventory keeps bloody. Ooh, there it is! I finally gained the karma from handing over Sergeant Teddy. Beautiful. Yeah, New Vegas never really found a good way to take all your weapons off you and then give you everything back. It just ended up presenting you with a ridiculously long queue of things re-entering your inventory. And here's old Julie, who was unfortunately a little bit injured. She apparently took a few shots during the war against the Vangrass, but she was victorious.
Welcome back, friend.
She doesn't even hold a grudge.
Rex's condition is way beyond anything we can handle. He requires brain surgery and some sophisticated cybernetics work, too. There's an old scientist named Dr. Henry, who reportedly specializes in this sort of procedure. He'd probably be your best bet. Last I heard, he was living up in Jacobstown, far to the northwest.
So we've got ourselves an answer heading up to Jacobstown. Obviously, we've already kind of been halfway there, to be honest, because we went up to Ranger Station Foxtrot, which is up in the mountains. So yep, that's only a short walk from where we've already been.
You seem to be awfully interested in my boy Rex here, and you've done some good work for me already. I'll tell you what. You promised to get Rexy here to that doctor, and I'll lend him to you. What do you say?
Sounds like a good deal to me. So here we are, heading back west from Foxtrot, just back there over towards Jacobstown. There should be nothing major here, for example. Like, these guys will completely leave you alone as long as you keep your distance. And the Mancers should be no trouble against the shotgun. And honestly, now that I've got and stay back and a riot shotgun, even the flipping Cazador should present no problem whatsoever. Assuming, of course, I can make it before dark. After dark, this becomes all a little bit more on the confusing side, because it's 8 p.m. and under the effect of this mod, as you can see, things get dark really, really quickly. And here we come on the slightly bright but not too bright lights of Jacobstown.
Welcome to Jacobstown, human. You're free to walk around. Just don't stare at the Nightkin. They don't like people looking at them.
Thank you, slightly mysterious dark figure who I can't tell exactly who or what you are. And here we are inside the much better lit lodge. Hello there, Dr. Henry.
I assume this is about something important?
Yes, a little dog needs your help.
It's neural degradation. Biomed gel can only preserve a living brain for so long, so you'll need to find a replacement. I haven't left Jacobstown in years, but there was one woman in Novak. Gibson. I remember her living with a pack of hounds. Aside from her, I know that the Fiends and Caesar's Legion fight alongside dogs. There could be viable specimens among them, if you can get to them.
Alright, and let's go get ourselves a new brain for old Rexy here. Boy, you just stay here for the moment, alright? So of course, we're gonna try and get Looper's brain to insert the brain into Rex to make Rex better, or rather give Looper a new body, because that's how brains work, but never mind, I've talked about this before. Hello there, Anthony.
The mechanical dog you have with you. Where did you get it?
I don't actually have a mechanical dog with me, okay? It's currently standing in Jacobstown, but he can just sort of magically see it anyway, dear oh dear. Got him in New Vegas.
Oh? Such things are common in Denver, but I didn't know that other cities had them as well. I ask because Kaisar once had a similar pet, but it was lost during a battle.
And I would really like to just borrow your dog's brain for a bit if I could.
Cyberdog? Like the ones I've seen up in Denver? I know what you're talking about. And it would make Lupa immortal, in a way.
And is that a yes by any chance?
You give Lupa a worthy death in the arena, and her brain is yours. Don't let your guard down just because she's old, though. Oh, and standard arena rules still apply. You don't get to wear armor, and you get only a machete for a weapon.
Oh, I promise I'll totally be obeying those rules. And grab the gun, and grab the ammo. And down she goes. In a what the heck? I'm technically still benefiting from Rex's perk, even though he isn't actually bloody here. Yeah, basically he just kind of flags useful stuff. So the guns kind of show up, and so do the bodies, because the bodies actually have useful stuff on them. So kind of they're highlighted as a result. Very nice. And now Looper, of course, let me just quickly dig out her brain. Lovely. So that's now 2 slaves, 2 NCR personnel, and 5 dogs just in the arena. And it's been, I think, kind of in-game about 3 days since I kind of put the first corpses here in this arena.
I set up the fights, keep track of prisoners available, and make sure the arena's cleaned up.
So bad at your job.
Got a problem. Could use your help. Been having trouble with NCR mercs harassing the town, and they just showed up again.
Oh sure, why not? This is a very easy, nice XP dump. So, unfriendly persuasion. Fortunately, with high speech or indeed high NCR rep, I can just get these guys to wander straight off. So I'm a hero in the NCR and you need to leave, or indeed speech of 65 and they'll just go away too.
I've always known when to fight and when to back down, and it seems to me I ought to back down this time. My men and I are leaving. You won't see us around here again.
And off they go, lovely. That is literally it. That's the entire quest. Could this be the easiest, shortest quest in the entirety of New Vegas? Possibly. Certainly amongst them. But it is only 250 XP, so it's hardly a massive experience dump there. Oh, and in one of the bungalows at the back of Jacobstown, by the way, I've always liked this. This guy here, who was killed during a card game. Why was he killed? Because he made the ever so slight mistake of putting down 5 of the same card. 5 King of Diamonds. Marvellous, well done. So the other guy presumably shot him immediately for being a dirty cheat. Oh, and of course, do not forget the Mount Charleston snow globe on the front desk as you pass through. Lovely, that is an extra snow globe there for some extra free money from Jane. And hello, boy, don't worry, I'm back with a new brain for you.
Exceptional synapse responses. Descended from some type of cattle dog, I imagine. If you want me to transplant this brain into Rex, he'll become more durable.
All right, go right ahead.
Have a seat. This will take a while.
And Rex has gained Blood of the Legion, making him harder to kill. So basically just a standard health top-up. 600 XP, and obviously Knight has indeed fallen. So let's see how Rex is feeling now. Happy Bark! Yes, how are you feeling? Happy Bark indeed! So that's the quest completed. We don't actually need to go and see the King to turn it in or anything. So we'll speak to the King later. No need to rush that. Rex, why don't you head back to Freeside for now? So Rex returns to Freeside to go and hang out with Elvis. So he'll make it back to the King all by himself and we'll check in with the King later. I, meanwhile, will stay the night here. This is an excellent place to be. Pretty much every bed in this entire place you can use. There is rad-free water in the bathrooms upstairs at the end there. And indeed, there's plenty of food in the kitchen. Now, with all that done, that is 5 out of the 6 possible arena fights. If Benny were still alive, he'd have been captured at the fort, and you can choose to fight him in the arena. Same rules apply. Both of you get machetes. Of course, you can drop guns in the arena and kill him with guns if you want. Fun fact is, if you actually take on Benny in the arena and then you kill him, he has Maria on his body, but he doesn't use it during the fight, which is interesting. Maybe he doesn't have any ammo on him. I'm genuinely not sure. I can't remember off the top of my head. Actually, that would make sense. It would be very elegant and clever of the game if they gave him Maria but just didn't give him any ammo for it, so he has a reason to not use it. Yeah, I'd need to double check that, but I suspect that's what the game did. And sadly, with all of that done, we're still only accepted by Caesar's Legion, not liked. So yeah, it's a little bit difficult to get yourself idolized by the Legion. And finally, on to Caesar himself. Of course, Benny would be kneeling down here tied up, but isn't here today. So instead, straight on to Caesar. Though do take a moment to admire the fact that he does have what's clearly an old world, really quite nice detailed map of the dam itself on the table. He's planning for the dam offensive already, and he's got himself a lovely old world map to help out with it.
You're the courier who caused so much trouble for my legion, and yet you dare come before me. The garrison I established at Nelson has been wiped out. You even disrupted a promising weapons deal with the Van Graffs. So tell me this, because I really want to know. I am feared, with good reason. But you, of all people, dare to come here and stand before me, the mighty Kaisar. What were you thinking?
Well, one, I've done more to you than that. Don't forget I also wiped out literally everyone in Cottonwood Cove. That's a bigger deal. And two, the Van Graaff thing was not my fault. I didn't convince the Van Graaffs to scrap the deal. I was just there working for them. Really, that's Gloria Van Graaff's fault. Blame her. So let's just play along with Caesar for now. How exactly can I serve the Legion?
I like the servile attitude. Keep it up. The time is fast approaching when my Legion will assault the Great Dam and invade the West. Before that happens, I want Mr. House knocked out of the game. A quick 1-2 punch, with you doing the punching.
Generally, when you're speaking to Caesar, go for the most toadying, groveling answers possible. He likes that, and it can sometimes get you just a tiny bit of extra Legion fame.
Down the hill, at the west edge of camp, is an old building. It was here when the fort was taken in 2277. Inside the building is a hatch. And inside that hatch are two steel doors that bear the sigil of the Lucky 38 Casino. Now that same sigil is on the platinum chip you were carrying. Isn't that interesting? Even more interesting, there's a slot about the same size as the chip on the console that opens the hatch. So you know what I think? I think the platinum chip opens those doors. Doors that can't be pried open or drilled open or blasted open. Because all that, I tried. I want you to destroy whatever you find in there. And then I want you to come back here and tell me about it.
And that's all Caesar's got to say. He wants whatever's in that bunker destroyed, and House wants you to go in and investigate, but hasn't really said what he wants you to do. And time for arguably the most disappointing thing in all of New Vegas, this massive great secret bunker, this thing that, you know, Caesar couldn't break open or blow open or whatever. Let's open it up and enjoy the massive kind of cranky vault door experience of inserting the platinum chip. Oh wait, just did that. Caesar apparently couldn't get through that with, like, dynamite and whatever, which is ridiculous. I wanted to have a big vault door, big kind of, like, whoosh, crunk, 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 crunk. I wanted to do all of that, but it doesn't. It feels really bloody flimsy, which is kind of annoying. Anyway, in we go to the Securitron vault, where we're straight into the effect of rads. So, some nice Radex will sort that out. Hello, Mr. House.
I see you reached your destination safely. Shall we get to work?
Now, what do you want me to do here, Mr. House?
As you know, the Platinum chip upgrades my Securitron's operating software. Well, there's an army of them here. The Securitrons policing this strip are a fraction of the total number manufactured. The rest I stored here. I need you to manually upload the data from the chip to the facility's primary computer. There's a terminal at the other end of this facility. There's a complication. While I can broadcast to this screen, I can't control any of the facility's systems. That means I can't deactivate its security bots, most of which appear to be active according to the status board I'm looking at.
So security to take care of, that's no big deal. We can deal with that in a second. House wants these turned on. Caesar wants this place destroyed. Always side with House. Even if you're ultimately planning to side with Caesar, side with House anyway. Because siding with Caesar here and blowing up the vault, House knows what you've done, and thus you've made an enemy of House, and he'll turn on you the next time he sees you, which makes life more complicated down the line. If you do what House says, and you turn the Securitron army, Caesar has no eyes down here. He's no bloody clue what you've done. He just assumes you've done what he asked anyway. So you may as well side with House under all circumstances. So in we go here. We got some robots. Well, that's fine. I think these guys will go down pretty bloody quick, in fact. Don't really need to worry about these in the slightest. Basic Protectrons. Got security terminals here to turn off the security. There we are. Got through that. And now we can just turn off the turrets. Marvellous. And got that first time as well. Lovely. And now the Protectrons are standing down as well. There is a third terminal, Sentrybot Operations. But sadly, that one is a little bit broken. This is yet another bloody reason, by the way, why you always, always, always side with Mr. House, which is if you side with House and upgrade the system, then the vault is fine, unless you never fight the sentry bots. If you blow it up, there's a massive general alert across the vault, and as a result of that, the sentry bots come and try and kill you. So, you know, there's no reason to side with Caesar. Side with House, always. The sentry bots in question are in here, by the way. This door can't be opened right now under any circumstances. It just opens automatically if you blow up the vault on your way back out again. Anyway, we should be 100% safe in here, because the Protectrons have stood down, and the turrets have stood down as well. Instead, we've just got all of these robots here. A lovely, massive army of Securitrons. Very, very nice. If you can actually hack both of those terminals, so as a result, if you came here when you've got a science of 75, or you can get it up 75, there is literally nothing here that poses any threat to you. You can just kind of run through this whole area. So, through to the final computer room. Another selection of Securitrons right here. Let's get them upgraded, shall we? Lovely. There we are. The massive crashing and banging begins. We get 250 XP immediately, and these guys start being upgraded to the Mark II. And let's see what Mr. House has to say about this.
Your work here is done. Return to the Lucky 38 so we can discuss next steps. You have a very bright future ahead of you. Thanks to your actions today, so does the rest of mankind.
Oh, he's a class act, Mr. House, you can't deny. So, back to Caesar. This would normally be the point where you decide what to do with Benny. Fight him in the arena, have him crucified, just murder him where he stands, or indeed release him. But if you release him, the Legion goes immediately and permanently hostile, so probably don't do that. But instead, we can skip straight to the next bit. Hello, Caesar.
I felt the ground shake a while ago. I'll take that as a sign you've got the job done. Let's press on, shall we? As I was telling you before, I want Mr. House out of the picture. You have an interest in his death, too. If he knows that you destroyed his gadgets beneath the fort, he will strike back. You know where to find him. How he dies, I leave up to you.
And of course, simply agree with what Caesar says, always just agree. Let's just quickly speak to the other lads around here, pick up a few side quests from them. So Lucius wants a firing mechanism for the boomers for some artillery, and Vulpes Inculta over here wants me to go check in on a gambler who lives over in Vault 21. Fine, we will go and do that in time. We won't be doing it just this second. Instead, with all of the arena fights done, let's check in with Mr. House and see what he wants doing next. First things first, a couple of extra snow globes for Jane.
Mr. House is just pleased as punch you got those old Securitrons back online, sugar.
Oh, I'm so glad. Anyway, here's some snow globes.
You do? Why, that's just wonderful.
And that, I believe, gets me up to, yep, over 20,000 caps. Marvellous. Hello, Mr. House. What's up next for us?
The foundation is laid. My Securitrons on the Strip are upgraded, and those at the fort ready for action. Now it's just a matter of adjusting the attitudes of some lesser groups while we wait for Caesar's Legion to attack Hoover Dam.
And what exactly did you have in mind, Mr. House?
Outside New Vegas, at what was once called Nellis Air Force Base, resides an unusual tribe known as the Boomers. They are, shall we say, aggressively reclusive. They have several howitzers they fire at anyone who dares approach the base. Artillery of this sort has a range of several miles. If it's going to fire on Hoover Dam, I want it firing at my targets. If not, then I want to make sure that the Boomers don't sign similar treaties to fire their guns in support of the NCR or Caesar's Legion.
Alright, go and take care of the Boomers, got it. And up to level 21 as well, marvellous. And let's just get a little bit of repair, a little bit of survival, and some energy weapons. Lovely. And you know what? I think that will do for now, ladies and gentlemen. Next time, I think as we've done a little bit of work for the Legion, we will go and instead do a little bit of work for the NCR. Fair is fair. And once we've done a little something for them, I have something else in mind to take care of in and around the Strip as well. So, that's next week, ladies and gentlemen. But in the meantime, I've been John. This has been many a true nerd. This has been Fallout New Vegas Survival Mode with the J Sawyer mod. Thank you very much, and goodbye. I want everyone to get into a single highly explodable thing, and then I want none of these 30 people to blow that thing up while everyone else is on it. Are there any planes here that aren't on fire or broken? No! I'm almost with you! Which has been going spectacularly well so far. Right, I'm going to- Oh no! You utter bastards!